microbiome is all of the microorganisms that are found in a particular environment. That could be your gut, it could be ocean water, or it could be soil. It's really important for us to understand what is a healthy microbiome. So maybe in your gut, you're healthy, we want to know that, but everyone's gut microbiome is different and it changes. And so even if you take a population of healthy individuals, they'll all have something slightly different, which makes it quite difficult to understand what's healthy and what's disease. Well, we're starting to do some of this in my team. So the problem is that these are very complex data sets. There's not a clear individual signal. And so we're actually using things like machine learning to try and start teasing out the signal of what is a disease state or what is a healthy state, what are the microbes that actually represent markers of disease. Having worked out these markers for disease, the question is can we change it back to a healthy state? And so that's one of the longer term aspirations, but that will require us coming up with hypothesis and then going back in the lab and testing this and then actually then seeing if we can actually rectify these disease microbiomes. There are some really interesting cases for where metagenomics is now being applied. For example, people have found bacteria that can offer resistance to fungus, and they're now being applied to crops as a fungicide. The most interesting case that I've read recently is actually where people have used the bacteria that are normally found in corals to make bricks. They could really try and start addressing some of these major challenges that modern society faces. So, for example, plastics and plastic waste in the world's ocean is really in the media a lot. So the interesting thing is when scientists look at those tiny pieces of plastic, actually every single one of those has a mini microbiome. There's little bacteria and microbes living on them. So, and when people take off those microbes, you actually see that the plastic is actually being degraded, that those microbes are eating the plastic. So the key thing for metagenomics is, can we harness what we can understand about those microbes and accelerate the rate that they're degrading the plastic? So metagenomics, one of the applications is actually in the medical arena and actually thinking about correcting a disease individual. So one treatment for Crohn's disease, for example, is actually to have a fecal microbiome transplant. But what you're really doing is you're taking the bacteria from that healthy individual and putting it into the disease state. So what we want to do with metagenomics is to actually dissect, work out those key bacteria that are important for making you healthy and put those in a pill, and then that's far more pleasant for the person, and also it's much safer because we know what we're transferring. Each one of these individual data sets on their own are quite large, and so as sequencing costs diminish, actually the bottleneck is actually going to be analysing the data. So what my team does is we provide a resource that allows people to upload their data, and then we will analyse that, so we'll do all the computation and then make their results available such that they can look at what's in their particular sample and which microorganism may be present and what they may be doing. But by doing this across for everyone and across all samples that have been collected for metagenomics, we can start having this more global overview about biodiversity, and also because all of the data sets have been analysed in a uniform fashion, it becomes much easier to spot patterns, identify organisms that are occurring in different environments, and therefore bringing this all together allows us to really see the trends in a much better way.